and cheating the 2007 elections in Maguindanao involving three political dynasties. Hello and welcome to the Tamano Perspective, the show where we give opinion and analysis to make you make sense of the headlines. Tonight we take a look at family, particularly political families. President Pinoy is the son of two powerful Philippine political icons, and he is set to give his second State of the Nation address in but a few days. Meanwhile, the heirs to three political dynasties are entangled in allegations of cheating in the 2007 elections in Maguindanao. In last year's SONA, President Pinoy highlighted eradicating corruption and job creation as priorities during his first year in office. He proposed what he called public and private partnerships as the solution to renewing investor confidence and creating job opportunities. Unfortunately, so far, 10 infrastructure projects have approval remain merely in the planning stages. Now, there are some who have suggested that the structure itself of these partnerships aren't flexible enough. Although Pinoy has had some success in cleaning house, with most of his energies directed at uncovering corruption of the previous administration, and this includes the Garcia plea bargain deal, the fertilizer fund scam. Now, closer to home, the Supreme Court recently announced a decision on the Hacienda Luisita issue. Pinoy isn't the only interested party in the Luisita cases, but until a fair settlement is achieved, Hacienda Luisita will always be a source of criticism, particularly in regard Pinoy's commitment to agrarian reform and social justice. While Pinoy is heavily involved in stamping out corruption, he should not neglect his equally important duties. Now, aside from making GMA and her administration accountable for past misdeeds, this is not enough. Pinoy has a country to run. Perhaps to make him focus on his administrative duties, he should hurry up and choose the next ombudsman. It can be a man or a woman, doesn't matter, but it must be someone with real integrity. Once that's done, the new ombudsman can take care of running after the corrupt. And so Pinoy can focus on other equally pressing and important presidential work. From a nationally famous political family, the Aquinos, we move to a family whose infamy has become known nationwide, the Ampatuans. The former ARMM governor, Zalde Ampatuan, accused of the 2009 Maguindanao massacre, is grasping at straws, trying to get free by pointing the finger at his father and brother, yet offering little evidence to prove that his role was any less than theirs.
Unang-una, hindi ko naman ikinahiya maging isang Ampatuan. Masakit mang tanggapin, masakit mang isipin na bakit pa Ampatuan to ay family ang papalitan mo. Pero dahil yun ang isang bagay na kailangan, dapat tanggapin natin.
In his desperate bid for freedom, he has started to sing about the empire that his father created and headed.
Noong time na yun, sa century ko, dumating sila. Sabi ko, saan kayo galing? Sabi niya, galing kami sa Makati dahil pinatawag doon sila.
Nino po?
Ni First Gentleman Arroyo.
Apo. Sino po ang pinatawag?
Si yung tatay ko, pati si Engineer Nori Unas. Then, ang instruction sa kanila is kung paano isiro si present President Pinoy na dating tumagpong senador, si Senator Lito Cayetano, at saka si Senator Ting Lacton.
And this has been confirmed by former election supervisor Lintang Bedol.
Kinuwento niya sa akin na sinabi doon ng Pangulo na tatlong tao ay kailangan bigyan ng siro. Si Aquino, Cayetano, at saka si Lacson.
Bedol and Zaldi have confirmed the allegations that GMA and her husband were personally involved in the cheating in Maguindanao during both the 2004 and 2007 elections.
Hello, guys. Ma'am.
So will I feel lead by more than 1 AM?
Well, if it's young age, that's advantage, ma'am.
Some claim that Zaldi's revelations are part of a grand scheme so that the smartest and most able of the Ampatuans, Zaldi himself, will be set free. But whatever is the real motivation, the upside is that Zaldi has exposed the cheating and corruption that were the hallmarks of governance in Maguindanao during GMA's watch. One person who must be thrilled about Zaldi's revelations is senatorial candidate Coco Pimentel. Now, having lost to Mig Zubiri in the allegedly rigged elections of 2007, his savior comes in the most unlikely of form. Up for grabs is the 12th Senate seat, which Miguel Zubiri obtained by a mere 18,000 votes, with the Maguindanao votes giving the final winning boost. Coco's electoral protest uncovered 257,000 spurious votes, which would mean Migs should not have been proclaimed.
Ako yung natutuwa na at last, no, itong aking malungkot na pakikibaka laban doon sa dayaan noong 2007 at last confirmed ng isang major player o isang taong makapangyarihan.
Migs has of course filed a counter-protest and is claiming that they have both been cheated.
Kung ako ay dapat hindi umupo bilang senador, di dapat hindi din siya umupo bilang senador dahil meron po tayong napatunayan na na-benefit po siya dito sa dayaan na nangyari sa Metro Manila.
One thing that we may have forgotten was how utterly absurd the initial election results were in Maguindanao in 2007. Firstly, the results were 12-0 in favor of all of GMA's senatorial candidates. Secondly, the sole Muslim candidate, Kiram, wasn't even in the top spot, which is odd considering that Muslims generally vote fellow Muslims. Worse, initially the number one spot went to Chavit Singson. Now, no one could explain how an Ilocano governor would get the most votes in Muslim Maguindanao. But the worst was yet to come. After it was clear that Chavit did not have a chance at winning, guess who magically became number one? Migs Zubiri. Let's shift from political families to what in the Philippines is a politically incorrect form of family, the homosexual family, and the issue of gay marriage. Lately, gay marriage has become an international issue. But the truth is, same-sex marriage has been legal in 10 countries. It's recognized by another 6 countries, even if in those countries, they don't perform the ceremonies there. In another 23 countries, they recognize what is known as a civil union. In the U.S., in New York, the state has become the 7th state to allow same-sex marriages. Now, not to be left behind, the Metropolitan Community Church in Baguio recently performed 8 same-sex marriages, much to the chagrin of the Catholic Church.
Sana mas ma-inspire yung iba. And more respect naman sa mga kagaya namin.
Not only do I love him, I'm in love with him. And he is the best person I have found.
Definitely the church has every right to take a strong and definite stand against gay marriage. In fact, even in Islam, homosexual sex and the idea of gay marriage is also forbidden. However, like the debates on the RH bill, when Congress decides to make arguments for or against proposed legislation, the argument should be secular and not religious arguments. Whether it be the RH, divorce, or a law allowing gay marriage, part of the modern Western democratic paradigm is that our policy debates must be founded on secular arguments. Because when you raise religious objections, it just destroys all debate. Because how can you argue against the divine? This is part of the reason why we have a clear separation between the church and the state. So let's keep the government out of the church, and the church should also stay out of government. Up next, we have an interview with the one and only Teddy Boy Locsin to discuss the past and the upcoming State of the Nation addresses. This is the Tamano Perspective.